And this is the second time that you're loading up the big truck. And talk about the first time, the outpouring of support from the community, from not just from the Bronx, but beyond.
Well, the first time we filled up a quarter of an 18-wheeler, and with the outpouring of support from Channel 12 and Channel 2, the Daily News and the Bronx Times, we actually filled up the whole track.
And how does that make you feel, knowing that you're helping people?
Oh my God, it's amazing. It makes me want to cry all the time. I cry all the time. I haven't stopped crying since 2 weeks ago.
And what is it that's touched you the most about this whole effort?
The outpour of support from the community. The community and people from New Jersey and Connecticut and Pennsylvania and Long Island. It's just amazing how many people have touched my heart.
How did they hear about this effort?
Well, it all started out with just a little idea, a little flyer, and my husband, PJ, went and just gave it to two neighbors, and from that, it just blew up.
Wow.
It just blew up immediately.
What types of things are you getting from down here?
Paper towels, baby wipes, diapers, clothes, garbage bags, cleaning supplies, toiletries. There's just so much stuff, kids' toys, anything that has to do with babies, baby formula.
And how did you get in touch with this truck company to drive this stuff up?
Well, I actually got in touch with them through a radio station in Alabama. I called up the 211 in Alabama and made contact with the radio station. The radio station then in turn heard me on the radio, and the truck driver called me back and said, I'm coming out.
Wow, so you drove from Alabama, got here this morning, and going back in right
3 hours? He's actually going back, but he was supposed to pick up in Pennsylvania. I made a contact in Pennsylvania that has 6 or 7 pallets worth of stuff, but I don't know if he can fit it on the truck.
Right, right. And he's doing this on his own dime?
Yes.
And so this is an effort that goes beyond the road. Many states.
I mean, it goes anywhere from New York to Pennsylvania down to Florida. I actually had a friend on Facebook, and she's in Taiwan, and she heard about it.
Not yet.
She actually sent donations.
I just came back from Taipei.
Really?
Taiwan. Yeah.
Oh, wow.
Just 3 days ago I was there. So, where do we go from here? Is the third truck next?
Yes, it is. Yes. I will have a truck here every 2 to 3 weeks until the donations stop running out. And then after this, I'm going to try and take on Tennessee and Mississippi and go from there.
This is just going to Alabama right now.
Yes.
We know other surrounding states are affected. How do you ensure that these goods get to the people who need them? Do you hook up with the Red Cross? Or?
No, I actually don't hook up with the Red Cross. Roland, the truck driver, actually delivers it himself to the people, and he distributes it out.
Wow.
And I also made little individual goodie bags for the kids, with a teddy bear, a stuffed animal, a book, a juice box, and some candy in it to give them some hope.
Did you ever live through a natural disaster?
The only natural disaster I lived through was the 1992 storm here in Seattle, and that was about it. That's where there was flooding. I've never lived through a tornado, a hurricane. You know what? I am so... People who live in Alabama and who live in those states that are affected by a tornado make me so strong and make me want to do this.
Thank you so much, Patricia.
Thank you.
All right.
Oh, I'm sorry.